Welcome back to U Cypher and our sport ne superstars. This is time for the game that will determine if we will have a draw match today or if the Sherdils will lose. I present to you the magical world of Dota 2.
Welcome back to U Cypher, Nesport, Nay Superstars. My name is Vivek, with me is CloudX, and you're watching the Sherdils take on the Yakshas. The Yakshas in their dugout, loud and proud, and surely why the hell not? They're at the top of the table. They've been performing phenomenally well. The Dota team is having great success. CS1 as well today. It's a good day for them.
Yep, they've been doing pretty well, but Sherdils have shown that they're no pushovers either. We've seen them being one of the only few teams at U Cypher that know how to close out a game when they have the advantage. Just yesterday, in fact, we saw them play versus Marksman, and they had a hell of a time, a hell of a game. I'd like to see if they're going to go with something from, something that worked for them in the last game. The Luna did seem to be working against Mage in the previous game. I think we could see Sherdils going for a Luna pick themselves. But we know that they love running the Spectre as their core. Both teams actually love running the Spectre as their core. So I'd be super surprised if they didn't go for it.
5 seconds remaining.
Yep. First couple of bans, Sherdils, they're targeting the Yakshas. And Yakshas, they're targeting the Sherdils. This isn't a game of Dota 2. It's two teams that know each other really well and just don't want to play against what their strengths are. Last ban, I don't know if you're going to ban out the Spectre straight away. The Yakshas have first pick.
Well, they haven't first picked the Spectre so far. If anything, I think they're going to first pick
the Dire's turn to pick.
It's an option. It's an
Lich,
option that's been
Crystal
working.
Maiden, what are you thinking?
I mean, they've been running the Lich at every opportunity to get, so yeah.
Lich.
Okay.
It's a punk signature at this point.
Yep, the draft, not so much a draft, but just intervals in time before the players pick up exactly what we know they're going to pick up. Punk picking up the Lich. The Sherdils, their two supports are Opa as well as Disruption. Now, Opa's played the Winter Wyvern a fair bit.
Radiant's turn to pick.
There is
just an interval in time before I name a hero and that hero gets picked. That's the draft, folks.
Turn to pick.
Hey,
oh, wow,
they're
going
to switch things up. They're going to pick up the Doom.
I mean, he wasn't banned for a change, so they're going to go with him as their opening pick. I'm not a fan of this team at all. But it is a hero that Khan's has been running every now and then, so they'll go with what they're comfortable with. Yakshas, one pick on the board for them. Now they've spotted the Doom coming out. What do they go for?
Radiant's
like an anti-mage pick,
wouldn't
be half bad.
Okay,
nice. Nice cover it is. They should be VP on the Night Stalker.
Yep. And I'm presuming Clockwork's gonna get banned out in this phase by Yakshas.
Yep. Clockwork is a decent
seconds
core
left
for Sherdils.
By my count.
One that works quite well versus the Lich and the Night Stalker.
5 seconds remaining.
They've got their defensive support in the form of the Winter Wyvern. Something offensive does seem nice. If it's not going to be the Clockwork, I'd like to see a Slada coming out here. I think that makes some sense as well. It's been a while since you've seen Invisible Roaming Force, though. I mean, I wouldn't be too against a Bounty Hunter being picked up by Sherdils. Given how long these games go, the track goal could really start to add up and give them the much-needed advantage in the late game.
I mean, I don't mind the Bounty Hunter either. I mean, Punk has been telling us time and time again how he gets no item progression beyond upgrade to his moves. If you're pushed by sentries for a long time.
Here's the Radiant ban.
That Lich is not going to have anything beyond moves.
Well, the Void's been banned out alongside that Silencer, while Joggernaut's been banned out from Yakshas. One thing's for certain, though, we're not going to have any Silence on the floor now because of Sherdils' ban.
Yeah. The Void, I presume, is just a somewhat targeted ban against Khalnayak.
Khalnayak is 5 seconds remaining.
The stronger offlaners in this tournament, in my eyes at the least, and they're somewhat targeting each other here, both teams. Yaksha's opened by banning out 3 heroes that Khan's has played. The Visage is something he's played in the offlane as well. They're not going to take the chances, and they're trying their best to limit Khan's and his hero pole, while Sherdils, they're banned out the Void. Clockwork is still in the pool. Bunch of good 4 positions in the pool. Has Sherdils ever played an Earth Spirit?
I don't think I've seen them play the Earth Spirit.
The Dire! Get a
Disruption Earth Spirit, it's not something that's ringing a bell for me, though. I don't even think we've seen Yakshas play the Earth Spirit. VP hasn't gone the Earth Spirit himself. Mm-hmm. Blue Frog is one of the few that I remember running the Earth Spirit. I can't remember who the other one was. But I mean, Spectre's still in the play. Yakshas loves running that Spectre. I'd be very surprised if they didn't.
Radiant's turn
not been
to
banned
pick.
Out either. Sherdils chose to ban out the Tidehunter, who was oddly enough entirely ignored for the first phase.
Yeah.
Dire's turn to pick.
Okay. We're gonna see a Spectre getting picked up by Sherdils here. So this means Akrid has to move out of his comfort zone. Now, my memory of his hero pool in this tournament has been Spectre, Medusa, and Bloodseeker. Did you play this win?
Not that I remember, but a Bloodseeker pick would not be the ideal way to go for them.
5 seconds remaining.
It's pretty good versus Bloodseeker. Spectre is, I mean, she's mobile. She can jump the hell away with the horn in reality. Rupture won't do the damage when you travel that much of a distance in one flash. I don't know if Bloodseeker is the best choice here for young players, but if they want to end with
Razor. Yeah,
we've seen him run the Razor as well. That's what they're going to go with. Although I'm not entirely a fan of this. I mean, Doom knows who he's got to shut down in the fights. Winter Wyvern could turn the fight against them if the Razor steals away a fair amount of damage. Spectre, there's going to be multiple versions of her on the floor, which means the Razor
Five
may not always be
remaining.
Stealing from the right one. This feels like a draft where Yakshas have just chalked out a handful of heroes for each of the players, and this is actually what's happening because we discussed this with them. Each player has like 4 or 5 heroes that they're comfortable with, and when their heroes get banned out, they resort to the next best one that they can play.
Yeah.
Their drafts are not exactly synergetic with each other. It's just about can you play a certain number of heroes and will this hero be terrible? If he's not going to be terrible in a draft, we'll pick him up. And that seems to be what happened during the race.
He's not terrible, but I'm not sure he's the
Dyer's
best
turn to pick.
Anyway, Sherdils are going to go for their proposition. It's going to be the Sand King.
So like much control, so much lockdown coming out now, some AoE damage as well. But Sherdils are missing a way to take towers. That's what they should be looking for as their final pickup.
So they're looking for a one position that can take towers.
10 seconds.
I mean, he's not ideal at taking towers, but
5 seconds remaining.
Alacrity, he'll help take some buildings as well. Or you could go for maybe a Templar Assassin. There's no real damage over time on the side of Yakshas. Speaking of, the Venomancer's in the pool, and that, now that I think about it, seems to be the best way to
Radiance
go for
Radiance turn to back. Storm
to
back. Spirit.
Oh, Yakshas, they'll go with the Storm Spirit here.
Okay, so Appa, Storm Spirit. Appa's been really good for his team in the tournament. His Meepo yesterday, on paper we said that the Yakshas, not yesterday, a couple of days ago, I'm not really sure when, but on paper we said that the Yakshas had lost that game. Somehow,
seconds.
They hit down with a 15-minute mark with such a greedy lineup. Do the Sherdils have
5 seconds remaining.
Spirit? I think Doom's going to help in that department.
Yeah, Doom and Sand King both.
Yeah. And Spectre with the Diffuser Blade, it's going to be a pain for the Storm Spirit.
That is assuming they go for the Diffuser. We've seen a lot of Spectres just love
pick
to
up
rush
the Radiance.
Yeah, either the Vanguard into the Radiance or the Radiance rush.
Okay.
That seems to be good.
Dire's ban.
But
now.
That's where Yakshas' Storm Spirit will really add value. If the Spectre decides to be greedy and just go for that Radiance rush, Storm's going to come online in the mid-game phase with some items and levels, and they'll be able to jump and continuously pressure and kill that Spectre. Nightstalker, Storm Spirit, fantastic at diving past towers and scoring kills, but on the other side, Blue Wyvern is fantastic
seconds.
At turning fights around as well.
Yeah. I like the Omni Knight ban coming up.
5 seconds remaining.
It could have been a problem for them. In a way, the Yakshas will now be forced to draft a more traditional offlaner. Looking at the offlane pool, what have we got?
Legions in the pool. Though.
Legions
and
the
Venomancer.
Pool.
These two seem like the top picks here.
Dire's turn to pick.
Not so much of a fan. I mean, we've already seen what a Spectre does to a Timbersaw in the league.
Okay. Last pick for the Yakshas. It is a hero for Lion.
So Yakshas did ban the Templar Assassin. They were expecting a TA in mid versus the Storm. Storm is still not entirely secure.
Ten
a lot
seconds.
Of people in the pool that could still decimate him in the leading stage. The pop, the pop,
both
of those could be viable options here that come to mind. How's Yakshas looking in terms of their final pick though? We know it's going to be an off-lane pickup.
Thinking of the options they're
next. Radiant's turn to pick.
Centaur is, okay,
it's going to be the Centaur.
Centaur is something that many teams have run as a way to deal with the Spectre.
Yeah.
Keep
Stampede,
on,
run away.
Stampede and just run the hell away. But I'm not I'm not sure if I favor this Yakshas drop the diamond because now that I look at it, the storm kind of looks like a sore thumb just sitting
five
out there.
5 seconds yeah. remaining.
There were a fair few options that may have added a bit more value. For starters, you could have picked up a hero that goes for the Silver Edge earlier on at the middle lane. The Dragon Knight if you want to push. Templar Assassin if you were looking for some damage of your own. We've got enough initiation with
don't you dare pick time.
What?
Go with the Corp. This is an incredibly hard lane for Storm Spirit in my opinion. And a lot rests on VP and the early game rotations he can make on the Night Stalker. The Haunt is gonna be great, but then, like you mentioned, you've got the Stampede. I wanna see if Sherdils have won this draft though.
Yeah, I feel like Sherdils had the upper hand in the draft as well, but this is one of those games where Yakshas are on a clock. Because Razor's not the ideal core you want to be going to the late game with. Storm is great in the late game stages, but only if he gets a good early and mid game. Sherdils, on the other hand, they're tanky as hell. They've got ways to deal with physical damage. They've got mobility to deal with the Razor. And they've got a Doom to deal with the Storm Spirit. I'd love to see Khans rushing the Blink Dagger this game. I don't want to see him go for nonsense.
5 seconds remaining.
Yep. I'd like to see the Blink Dagger as well. You said the Yakshas have to end this game early. I look at their lineup and I see a sore lack of heroes that can take objectives. This is also going to be one of those games where Roshan is not going to be that easy for them or for either side.
For either side, actually.
Yeah. Sherdils, on the other hand, I like the draft a lot more. They've got lockdown, they've got late game security, good burst damage, something to control the mid game in the form of the co-op, and Doom, which is a good safety net to have when you have a well rounded draft. Doom by himself doesn't make a good draft. But when he's got heroes that complement him, such as the Sherdils lineup for this moment, I think he's going to do okay. I'd like to see the Blink as well. Just Blink in, make the Centaur useless, make the Storm useless.
Yeah, if you can shut down the Storm in the team fight and have the follow-up coming in with like a Sand King, Burrow Strike and such to finish off another target, I think Sherdils wins the team fight 9 out of 10 times.
Yeah. It's also, I mean, I do not like Lich as a first pick anymore in this patch. I think there are so many better 5 positions that you could have. You could pick a Shadow Shaman, you could pick up the Crystal Maiden if you wanted around the Storm.
I agree. But, you know, while we've been talking about Sherdils' strengths, they have some weaknesses in their draft as well. For starters, the Spectre Haunt, the Doom, as well as the Queen of Pain ult, they all have fairly long cooldowns. Even the Winter's Curse is a fairly long cooldown in my books. On the other side, Yakshas are not really cooldown reliant. Sure, there's the Chain Frost, which is going to be a while before it comes back online, but Razor can fight often, Storm can fight often, Night Stalker wants to fight often, and so too can the Centaur. So Yakshas have to display a new blend of aggression, unlike what we've seen before from them in this entire tournament, if they want to win this game.
Yep.
I don't think passive play is going to get them anywhere. They have to be aggressive, they have to be the ones making the first few moves. Preemptive plays, going to gank that Spectre will give them the victory here. Mm-hmm.
If anything aggression to some extent does begin in the lane, do you think running an aggressive try and giving Kalnag the matchup versus the Doom could benefit the Yakshas here?
I don't think so, man. I think you run the defensive try and just deal with the Doom in the laning stage, because if you have a Kalnayak versus Khan's matchup with Doom versus Centaur, I think Doom is just fine there.
Okay.
He's got the Scorched regeneration. If he manages to get the Unholy Aura from the side, those double edges may not work well enough. Because the way double edge works is you both end up taking damage. The victor in that skirmish is the one that has the higher amount of HP regen. And Doom pretty much wins that battle 9 out of 10 times.
Okay.
I'm not really sure why we keep having this pause. It seems like a tactical pause though. Something that's non-existent in Dota.
Yeah, I mean if anything, Yakshas just pick up the last hero and they all huddle and scream Yakshas at each other. But despite taking that break in the draft itself, they're going to take another one while we load. It's Mamacita who brought the pause. And I've seen Mamacita do this a bit. He has had a couple of tech issues. And this almost happens every game of the Sherdils. He's probably having a talk with his team, conversing with the game jockey, just trying to ensure that everything's running smooth.
Yeah,
he almost always has some technical issue.
He's jinxed. No Mirana picked this game though, that's a bit surprising. So, among the heroes that were ignored were the Mirana, the Clockwork, and to some extent the Tidehunter. He did get banned out in the second phase of bans, but the meta is just shifting ever so slightly from each game to game in at U Cypher.
Yeah. I think it was an oversight of sorts with regards to the Tidehunter. I think both teams forgot about it because, I don't know, I don't mind the Centaur, but picking up Tide is too tempting to let go. Anyway, Sherdils, they're grouped up. Not sure if they're really going to contest this rune. Akrid, he's just sitting in his tier 2. He's not even bothering approaching his rune. VP gets down the ward in the mid lane. So
this has sort of become the norm now at Ucypher. You don't go for your own safe runes, you go and contest the other side.
Yep. I mean, the only team to do this really well were the Akramaks with that early smoke gank, where the magic missile was set up for a perfect arrow from the Mirana. But now they're just wasting that. And Akrid's red.
30 seconds to
he's already broken the Winter Wave with smoke, apparently.
Yeah. Anyway, no one's fooling anyone. I don't even know what the Sherdils are attempting to do anymore.
Like we said, right?
I think Khans went and took a look
this
at the enemy.
This smoke rotation is only worth it if you actually get first blood, because otherwise you end up at 2 bounty rooms apiece again. And you've basically wasted that extra bit of gold to purchase the smoke.
So, yeah, I agree. I mean, you either smoke to scout a lane, or you smoke to drop a ward, so that helps you know where the enemy ward is, and you're getting an advantage in your lane. They didn't do either. They smoked, they walked around, they picked up runes. And the only good thing that came of this is that Opa and Disruption are in a really good position.
Appa missed his block.
Appa missed his block.
Do you know, I can't stress how hard his lane is going to be at this point. Because it's not just the block that went wrong for him. There's Disruption and Opa just waiting behind him.
Yeah, exactly. That's where the smoke really paid off. Now, Appa's called out his cell. The bounty rune has paid dividends. Mamacita holding on to a skill point. Appa goes in ahead. Mamacita needs to be careful as well, but here comes the cavalry. The Arctic Burn, the Butter Strike, Mamacita pounding away. Appa drops her Ironwood Brown, tries to heal up, but they've got more than enough. This should be first blood. And it's Disruption who gets it. Okay, so that smoke did pay off. They got onto where the old guy shrine used to be.
Nightstalker's been hanging about a little too long as well. Mamacita chose not to commit the Shadow Strike first. There's no more Arctic Burn available on Opa. It's on cooldown for a good 20 seconds. Sherdils off to a good start here, getting themselves first blood on the middle lane. Pain of Pain, getting some free farm time because Appa could not be back.
Mamacita's a level 2. Really go for the skill, I don't know.
Man, this is just such a painful way to start a Storm Spirit.
Yeah.
Like you said, Mamacita has crossed level 2 and he's not doing too badly in the HP department either. Mm-hmm.
He's going to keep making life difficult for Appa here.
Yeah, you know that Appa has that Tango on cooldown. He wants him to force out that salve, run through his consumables early on, because Mamacita will be able to call out a bottle before him, but it looks like he's queued up a secondary null talisman.
Yep, Disruption's also nearby, so they're looking to go once more.
I don't know if they can kill, though.
I think they know that BP had to make a base trip. Although BP could TP back to the mid lane. Disruption.
Yeah, well, I don't think this kill is going to happen unless Disruption waits around here for much longer. Because Appa's been told that the Sand King is missing, so they should know that he's in the vicinity.
Yes.
Anyway, Punk is going to scout him out now as well, and Disruption won't
Punk
be able to do
with
much.
No mana, just trying his best here. Disruption is going to stand, pass his fingers first, and Disruption will pick up the bounty. Now, VP,
coming
in from the north, Punk doesn't have a Frost Blast, and Disruption picks up both
wounds.
That brings him up to level 2, puts a point into the caustic finale as well. While Opa is gonna disrupt the creeps for VP, avoiding him from getting the pull. In fact, he's just chaining the pull here.
Yeah.
So he's denying an entire wave almost, but VP says he's having none of that. Takes the creep aggro away instead. Yakshas will reset the equilibrium on the bottom lane.
Oh, mid lane. Disruption. Appa canceled his TP.
Why?
So Appa was really low. Mamacita was really punishing him in the mid lane. Appa was going to TP away, which would have been the right thing to do. And level 1 Burrow Strike, I'm not sure if it could have got off to the Storm Spirit, but Appa pays with his life. That's the second death from the Storm Spirit in the mid lane within a span of 2 minutes.
But on the other side, Akrid is simply dominating that Doom on top lane. I mean, that Static Link is just working so well versus Khans. Khans didn't manage to get himself that Unholy Aura creep either. He only got himself Tornado creep. It gives him a little bit of armor with that toughness aura, but when Akrid is hitting for 112 bonus damage this early on, it doesn't mean much. Rivals had a fair bit of space too, but the Centaur's doing much better than that Doom on the other side.
Look at Akron, disruption goes in. Okay.
Again, Khan's loses 70 damage and he can't last in his lane anymore. Akron has 11 denies versus him.
I mean, the real victory so far in the early game for the Yakshas is that by running this odd aggressive try, they're really pressuring Rival. They've got the wall, they've got the hoofstomp. A kill on him could be huge. Where's the cold embrace? 2-1, he has it! He's gonna go for it! But the void is coming off cooldown. Is it enough with the double edge? It indeed is. Opa doesn't have the Arctic burn for a bit. And disruption in the mid lane. Can't do much while Akrit scores another kill to summon Khan. Khan's yeah.
But at the same time, Appa actually went down on the middle lane again. So Santing and Queen of Pain brought him down for the third time this game. He's 0-3-0. Queen of Pain is just decimating him on the CS charts as well.
Oh, Bung? Almost out of position there.
In the overall scheme of things, I still think that works out in favor of Yakshas. They got a kill on the bottom side of the map.
They're going to lose Appa again. Mamacita just goes in, pops the illusion rune. It's a level 1 scream, his blink is on cooldown. Disruption, 2 points in Barshai, could close the gap.
Tranquil
Mamacita.
Boots. He's got him. Oh, what? Yeah. How do you miss that? Major misplay coming out from him because with the caustic, I think he might have even been able to get the kill there. Appa has no choice but to move into the jungle now. It's slow, it's going to be painful, but he cannot farm in the lane anymore. But they're already pinging out which direction he might have gone in.
I think Disruption needs to hang around the bottom lane a little bit more. Just try and ensure that Spectre gets off to a good start. It's only the Centaur and the Lich for now. A kill on the Centaur is a possibility. Dyer's they do have 1 point in Desolate.
Mamacita though. He's gone on an expedition inside of the jungle. Appa's already popped his shrine and he isn't level 6. He even drops a ward and he sees him doing his shenanigans now. Walks in, stream along with the Shadow Strike. A few more auto attacks, might just get him the kill.
No TP's on the shrine.
Appa chose to fight. That was a mistake.
And he's got a TP. Top lane, they're going in on Khan. They sense their opportunity. Khan doesn't have a TP. It is night time, but VP's out of mana.
He just got a two-man war storm there, caught both the Nightstalker and Akrit. Mamacita, the star of the show so far, sitting at 3-0-1. While Storm Spirit is just clutching at straws, trying to get himself up to level 6 while Mamacita's crossed it. He wants to put it into the Sonic Wave, and that's what he's going to do. With a point in the Sonic Wave, with the Arcane Rune picked up, they could go to finish off Appa once again. But this time, PP's in the vicinity.
They want to bring down Mamacita, but without the crippling fear, it's a very hard kill. Mamacita takes almost no damage from the void thanks to the infused raindrop. Radiant's top tower needs to be careful. Okay. I think Mamacita's going to fall back.
Bottom. Khalnayak is in a bit of trouble. They do get the stomp off on Disruption, which stops him in his tracks. And Khalnayak will end up surviving with a sliver of HP. He's still doing much better than the Doom on the other side, though, I have to say.
Yeah, I mean, he's had Lich and the Nightstalker pretty much just sitting with him in the lane. Khan's has been left to dry here. And stack in the jungle. I don't know who claims the stack here, but I presume Khalnayak is just going to give it over to Appa. Mamacita sees this as an opportunity. He's going to start applying some pressure in the mid lane.
Arcane Rune is such a pain to deal with. Yep. Versus the Quark.
Disruption and Opa. They do see the Storm Spirit. Now, Storm isn't level 6 yet. He's level 5. They've gone in with the Arctic Burn. He's hit 6. He's got the zip and he gets the hell out of there. VP could turn this around. Disruption needs to be careful. He's got a couple of stick charges. But Punk is coming in. The crippling fear is there. Disruption. He went to clear the stack and could be punished for this. He could try to Butter Strike down. Mamacita's coming in. The Scream, it's not enough to bring down VP. And Disruption, well, he's pretty much left Mamacita all by himself. They've got the crippling fear. They're focusing Mamacita. The stick charge is not enough. He turned to drop the Sonic Wave, but the Void was there. And Akrit TP'd in with the Plasma Field. They bring down the Mamacita and put an end to his killing spree and lose nothing. Time and time again, teams are taking fights near the shrine. And they're not winning these fights. And they're not respecting how quickly everybody can get there.
What happened over there was Appa was actually level 5, but when the Splinter Blast hit on the neutrals, I think the EXP got shared. And he hit 6. So that level 6 ended up with him getting away, Razor's rotation completely on point. Most of the time you'll see Akrit playing passive and farming, but he has brought a change to his playstyle and it's paying off because he gets the killing spree and shoots himself on top of the net for a charge.
Yeah.
Now Khan's is in trouble. The wraparound is there. The Eye of the Storm expected.
Now
he's
going to DP.
He's not getting out of this. That's 105 stolen damage on the back of a maxed out static lead. Opa's also here, though. Oh no, he could be going down as well. Look at the damage from Akrit with one hit. If he connects on him, smack! One more ought to do it. Maybe two, actually. One more will do it. Never mind. Opa is just gonna go undercover with this Cold Embrace and die to be destroyed.
Disruption falling in the bottom lane. They commit the Chain Frost along with the Double Edge. Bring down the Sand King as well.
They've just exploded in this towards the end of this laning stage here. Really. Yeah. Yakshas have found themselves killed everywhere. And Appa is finally level 6, so he doesn't need to worry too much about Mamacita jumping and finishing him off.
No gold for you.
But Appa does need to find more of a recovery here. He is really far behind in terms of farm. And the only way he pulls back is not by continuously farming. He has to join the fights and ensure that he comes out on top. Yeah, but
I guess he's going to try and complete a Soul Ring and then maybe...
Oh no, he could be dead.
Mamacita goes in, the stream is there. Appa did have mana to Ball Lightning away. Horn comes in from Rival, he's chasing with the Spectral Dagger.
Yeah,
Appa dropping
deep.
Low, he's got a Remnant, he's got a couple of increased raindrop charges. They want Rival. Rival gets Appa, but is this really worth it? The Spectral Dagger wears off, so he's not got that free pathing. And Khalnayak TP's in as well.
Absolutely not worth it there for Rival to go in that deep. I mean, the damage was done. Storm was going to make a base trip again. His farm was slowed. Mamacita could have gone to farm at mid. Rival could have continued farming on bottom, but instead he chose to dive in past the tier 3 when all tier 1 still stand. Some seriously questionable decision making from him.
They see... I think they saw Disruption moving towards this top lane, and Appa's TP then as well. Akrit.
He's being bait though.
Yeah, he's just pretending to be bait for the time being. Khan can go in, Darkness pop, a quick zip from Appa doesn't really do too much, but look at the damage from Akrit as well as that Remnant. They bring down the Doom. Disruptions here, turns around with a Butter Strike. Mamacita, he's got to unload that Sonic Wave. He does, they're moving on to VP. VP will fall. Akrit with a lot of stolen damage, focusing Mamacita, gets the kill. It's actually Appa who does, while Akrit brings down the Sand King. Opa, without the Windows Curse, with the Cold Embrace, trying to stay alive, while Rival is chasing down Appa. He's going to get the Storm Spirit, but he's going to fall to the Remnant. It's a double kill for Rival. The victory here is that Akrit hasn't fallen a single time. And Pong, just by yelling at everyone, brings a lot of tenseness to the air.
That's still gold going in favor of Yakshas there. They're up by about 3,000 net worth now, and Akrit comes out of the clear victor and all of that. Not only does he get the gold for everyone dying around him, he was just standing there and soaking up the EXP. He's up to level 11. He's going to have the Eye of the Storm level 2 in just a bit. And, I mean, Yakshas have just found their momentum. Spectre coming in and dying once more has significantly slowed him down to the point where he's given up on either a Vanguard or a Radiance and he's just going for the Blade Mail first.
This is silly. I mean, when you got stronger late game, then you want to try and itemize for that. What's also problematic is that the supports on the side of the Yakshas have hit 6 earlier than the supports off the Sherdils. This is kind of playing out to be a huge factor in team fight. Now, Disruption on the Hunt, not yet level 6. Appa needs to be careful. He's looking for the deny, doesn't get it. Meanwhile, bottom lane, they're going on to Rival. Beautifully done.
They want this kill on Appa.
The deep observer ward paying off. Meanwhile, mid lane, it seems as if they managed to catch the Storm Spirit and they'll bring him down.
Some heavy commitment coming out. They do throw out a Doom, but that's another death in the Spectre. 12 minutes in, she doesn't even have a Blade Mail. What is going on here? They have shut down Rival so hard. Can they capitalize on this though? I mean, we know that teams at U Cypher don't really know how to capitalize on their momentum, or rather they have a hard time doing so. Yakshas, I think they're trying to make a statement here by showing that they can. They need to be able to take objectives now on the back of this wave of euphoria they're riding on. But one thing's for certain, Appa's had a terrible game so far. His Storm Spirit has just been the ire of the hatred.
Well, they do know that most of the Sherdils are hanging around this top lane and they're just looking for a trade. The left Khalnag pushing up the bottom lane.
That's a valuable plasma shield, spotting out the Sand King on the side and spotting out the gank being set up. Radiant's bottom tower faces a stiff wind. Things are coming out and Appa's in the vicinity.
Appa's looking to fight. He's got treads and a wand. He had queued up a soul ring, but he gave up on that a while ago. TP's in from the Sherdil to the bottom lane. It's only disruption for now.
So Sand King didn't put the point into the epicenter at 6.
That is a misclick.
And at 7 he goes for the butter strike.
Going in for Khalnag. Goes in for the butter strike. He's got the speed of blast. Khalnag does have the stampede, but does he want to commit it? He might have to because Mamacita is coming in from the north. But he's got support as well. He pops the hook. Rival goes in with the hunt. Immediate tripling here under the Sand King. Khalnag running around like a headless chicken. And well, the chickens lost the rest.
But Daddy's here and Akrit comes in.
He's committed heavily. Mamacita has the Sonic Wave. He's got the Cold Embrace, but the Eye of the Storm doing some serious work on Disruption. Disruption will fall. Akrit not going in for more.
They threw everything on that Centaur Warrunner. He took so long to go down. Akrit comes in and cleans up shop. And now they could even go for a Tier 1 tower if they're feeling confident.
Winter Wyvern is still not 6.
Punk has that Chain Frost if he wants to make a play, and Appa does have a TP available as well, so they can come in and take this tower, but it looks like Sherdils is just going to give it up. They'll go back to the Shrine, pop it and move towards the middle lane, where they're hoping to score yet another kill on Appa's Storm Spirit. Grail complete on Mamacita. Blink forward, picks up the Arcane Rune before Appa can get there. Mind games coming out from him once again, but now we're going to see Punk and VP move through the jungle. They have that Dire Observer Watch spotting stuff out next to the Shrine. They won't find anything. Exactly, they take the tower.
But, I mean, this is a small but significant decision coming out from the Yakshas. The Sherdils, they have a deep ward. They say heroes, they just rush in the direction. Last time they did this, they fought near the enemy Shrine. Storm Spirit hit 6, ran away. But Punk and VP, they're not going to overcommit just because they have vision. Instead, they're going to come and try and take an objective. Akrit gets the tier 1. They'll come back another day.
The way that the Sherdil's draft is built is essentially to find pickoffs and isolated heroes. But they're getting no room to find pickoffs. Yakshas is just grouping up now. They're going to move together. Appa's the only one that's taking the risk in farming by himself. And I say it's a risk, but he's actually farming deep inside his own jungle, right next to a shrine, where his allies can TP. So you can see him switching things up. He's not going for the Bloodstone Rush. He's just going to go for the Kaya first, which is going to give him a lot more fighting potential.
TPs are coming in the top lane. It's acted with a huge bounty upon his head, but Mamacita as well as Disruption just blink away and get the hell out of there. Khans, what's he picked up? 15 minutes in. Searching for the drums, it's been a rough start for Khans, and if you take a look at the net worth, I mean, he's poorer than the Storm Spirit, who's died a whole lot of times.
This is absurd. Storm Spirit should not be this high on the charts. Maybe it's because of some of the tower gold, maybe it's because of the 3 kills and 3 assists he's had. But there's also the fact that Appa died in quick succession, one after the other.
Yep.
So it's not like he'd had too much unreliable gold to actually give away. So his deaths were only a bit of a speed bump here, as opposed to a full stop. Mamacita's snowball has been stopped as well. I mean, he's stuck on the Bale, he's going for the Yules, but it's going to be a while before he gets it. And all the while, Akrit continues to chip away on towers across the map.
Yeah, they're just five-manning. I mean, not five-manning, but they're just grouping up and taking a tower, and it seems as if the Sherdils are not punishing them. Appa's all by himself, excuse me, Rival is all by himself in the bottom lane. I don't know what Mamacita can accomplish.
Rival's always farming with supports next to him. He's no longer alone ever.
Yeah.
They realize how high priority it is to get him his Radiance or to get him his next big item. He's gonna go finish the Blade Mail after all. He even picks up a TP but chooses not to put it into his backpack.
I think he can extend it cooldown. Switch it out with the Quelling Blade.
Or even the Stout Shield while he's farming secured like this.
Okay.
Anyway.
Haste.
Not like he's gonna be absolutely needed somewhere right now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I mean, he could go to the top lane and farm. Is under attack.
Looking for me.
Anyway, a quick item check. Storm Spirit did finish up the Kaya, and as I say that, we're going to see a smoke coming out from the rest of Yakshas.
Has Khalnag picked up his blink? No, he just got the hood. The stampede could be enough. Now they see the majority of Sherdils and where they are,
they saw the smoke.
And they spotted out the smoke. This isn't going to turn out too well for the Sherdils. They are moving up. Disruption does have that maxed out Butter Strike.
Centaur.
He's moving towards the Centaur. Khalnag smoked himself. The scan did clip from the side of the Sherdils. How do they respond? They move towards the mid lane. Akrit's TP'd here as well. They could just run straight into the Sherdils, but instead, they're moving into the Radiant jungle.
So Sherdils used the scan, they spotted the fact that there was someone there. Instead, they went around through the trees and dropped down an observer ward next to the shrine camp.
I missed that.
So by the time they spotted someone in that general area there, the centaur had already moved off.
Okay.
So no one ends up finding anyone.
Rival, bottom lane, TP in his backpack. Could this hurt him?
It most definitely could. I think it's time to swap it out again. There he goes.
I think he's got to swap that spectral dagger and get the hell out of there.
Well, Nayago, he found him!
Senses where he is, the hoof stomp is there. Stampede as well, active, making his way towards Rival. A quick hunt, but where does he hunt to? Well, he's managed to get away.
Somehow he's managed to get away here. But it's a defensive
But they're running
haunt.
After him. They're still running after him. I mean, VP did.
Bad
what
idea.
Apple is just zipping in. Now, Rival, he's got the blade mail, pops in a bit late. He got the Winter's Curse. VP pounding away on his own Storm Spirit.
That's what a terrible idea by Yakshas. I mean, you forced out the defensive haunt. You've got a momentum of. You've got a creep wave momentum going to the bottom lane. You might as well just go and take the tower instead of expending all of your mana to jump across half the map.
And this is not a good trade for the Sherdils. They're trading a tier 1 for tier 2. Are they going to come back to defense? They've committed the haunt. Mamacita is low on mana. Disruption has a TP. Khan's has a TP.
I mean, given that the Spectre was caught completely off guard, I'd say it's a decent thing. They're getting something for dodging that gang.
Okay.
Spectre continues to farm towards her lane. She's now up to 1500 gold. Just another 1500 to go before she picks up the relic. Or actually, a little more than 1500 to go before she picks up the relic. But it is some sort of progress coming out from Rival.
I don't know if this blade mail is really going to have any impact in teamfights.
I really don't think it. I mean, it's going to be a deterrent for the Razor and right click.
Yeah, but you can very easily.
There's so many ways to just kite her and beat her while she pops.
This is not a trade though. They're just giving up this tier 1 in the mid lane. What is the timing that the Sherdils are looking for? When is it that they peak? Are they waiting for the blink on disruption? Khan's has been rather. I don't know, hasn't gotten too much done besides that one Doom.
I'm not entirely in agreement with Appa's doing, by the way.
Oh, they're just moving towards the Stampede. Well, beautiful Winter's Curse. Holds acted as well as Kalnaika. But they're running onto Opa, and Opa didn't commit the Golden Gaze upon himself. Will end up going down. Disruption here with the Battle Strike. Mamacita with a quick
Nice.
But that Doom, man. Hoof Stomp. Beautifully done by Kalnaika, but there's no real follow-up. Rival's still in the trees. Nah, they don't know he's there.
Appa's chosen to go for the Orchid right after that Kayan, so no blood
from
the
Sonic Wave, Mamacita making use of that ward, but
he might die.
He's out of there, he's got the urn upon him. Okay. And they're turning onto the Spectre. The Blade Mail pays dividends, it secures the kill upon the Lich, and they're moving on for Rival. A lot of damage stolen and acted on a monster kill streak. Somebody deal with this Razor. Well, they just switched targets. They move back for the Storm. That's been the easier kill for the entirety of the game for the Sherdils. And now Akrit, isolated, going to be chased down. Mamacita blinks in. He's got the U Scepter. This is going to allow his team to catch up.
No.
But that's a lot of Doom
Sherdils
damage wasted.
Are in trouble. Sherdils are in trouble because the cavalry has arrived. Can they turn this around though? They've got the Butterstrike coming out. Mamacita jumps forward, but Kalnayak enters the party with a two-man stun. The Cold Embrace keeps Disruption alive while Akrit still runs. The Splinterblast is chasing him and it's gonna tag him. It's enough to get the kill. It's a monster kill streak taken away by Upa, but the fight is still going on behind as VP and Kalnayak will bring down Disruption. It's clean up on aisle 3. The Infernal Blade hits VP hard. There's the Mamacita blinking again. They're still going to watch her. Rival will haunt. And Kalnayak will fall. Or will he? He's popped the stampede. He tries to run, but Khans will slice him to bits. At the end of it all, Yakshas with a bit of a throw there. Just indecisiveness in those last few moments of the fight will be their undoing.
They lose 3, they get 5, they take the streak. Winter Wyvern has more gold than it's good for him. He's gonna. Well, his ambitions were small. He wanted arcane boots, but now he has 2.6k gold.
I hope he doesn't pick up a blink dagger.
What do you like to see?
There it is.
Glimmer Cape?
Glimmer Cape is exactly what he needed. He's got a layer of defense now for his teammates, Spectre. After that fight, she's picked up the... What?
What did he pick up?
Radiant's recipe.
Worthy tribute.
Why?
Stupendous!
It was a panic buy while she was... in the midst of a fight.
No, she died, she haunted. I mean, I don't know. But they finally dealt with the Razor. It was long, it was painful. And the Sherdils have realized that Razor is a huge problem for them. Opa on his own warding mission.
That was a dewarding mission by Opa, actually. VP went to deny his own observer ward. But you know that both enemies. Teams want Roshan, but the fact is neither team can get him. Akrid is going for the Lincoln Sphere next as well. Yakshas made a fairly odd decision there to fight 2 versus 4. They knew for a fact that the Nightstalker had TP'd up in the top lane.
Flag looking to fight again. Walks into the enemy jungle. VP all by himself. Opa's got that Glimmer Cape. They could turn this around. They've got the Sand King nearby, but they don't know where the rest of the Yakshas are. But yeah, it's good of them that they waited. Disruption has picked up his Blink Dagger.
And Appa's finished a full Orchid on the other side meanwhile, so they could jump the Spectre this time and almost assure themselves.
Oh, it looks like they're going to do that, but it's Khan this time who they're attempting to jump. Kalnag is running down the enemy offlaner. There's the Orchid. Khan is bought down rather easily there. Appa scores the kill. I'm actually going to look at KDA. And yeah, 4 kills, 8 deaths, 4 assists. Meanwhile, mid lane, VP is getting quite comfortable here, just pushing out by himself. Both heroes flying over trees and trying to stay alive. Here comes Appa. They've got detection, a sentry on the floor. VP is just running him down. Negative own charge committed, and they'll get the kill on Opa. Where's the follow-up? Where's the goddamn Sand King when you need it? VP tagged by the Veil of Discord. Appa's gone back, with Kalnaya just waiting patiently. Looking for an opportunity to jump in, goes in onto Mamacita. Quick bubble strike, but they didn't catch the Sand King. They didn't catch the Storm Spirit, and Storm Spirit ends up breaking down Mamacita, and he moves on for more. He secures the kill onto Disruption.
Some really strange stuff coming out from Sherdils. They're just standing about to get picked off one after the other. I mean, after one pick off, you probably just huddle up inside your base and wait to watch what the Yakshas are going to do next, but they're just getting jumped in by a center and a Storm Spirit time and again and getting punished for it. This was a near team wipe that should never have happened in the first place. Yep. It was a slow and painful team wipe that now transitions into a tier 2 tower. And now they're going to back away as well. They've got a pipe on Kalnayak if they want to make a double back and fight. But they're looking for Rival, who's still making progress towards that Radiance.
I was going to say the good news, but Khan just found Rival. He's gone in, he's committed the Stampede. Now Appa is here, where's the Spectre gone off to? With the Horn, he's somewhere next to Opa. Opa pops the Glimmer Cape. Where's the detection? Well, it's not on VP, but they're still going to chase. It's Akrid coming in from the north with a Haste Rune upon him. They're trying to run down the Sand King, but the Windmill's curse! It's pretty decent. Opa, though, not going to survive. He pops the Cold Embrace, he's drawing them towards him. They are low on mana. Where's Mamacita when you need him? Rival just running straight at them with that Blade Mail. The Chain Frost is there. Well, Punk schemes Nikal, but it's Akrid who might have to back off. The Sonic Wave brings VP really low. Mamacita wants the kill. The Infernal Blade from Khans, along with the Alpha Wolf, will ensure the death on the VP. Kalnayak all by himself. He's got no mana to work with. 10 stick charges might have to pop it. But there's another Infernal Blade. And Khans, with the Hoof Stomp, brings down Rivals before he falls. Here comes Appa. Zips in, Disruption all by himself. The Drum Charge giving him a little bit of movement speed, more than enough to blink away. While Khans will just TP the hell out of there. They lost Dyer's the Spectre, they got the Sentinel and the Night Stalker, they lost the Wind Wyvern as well. I don't think that's a win.
Didn't they lose the Storm Spirit as well somewhere there? No, they didn't actually. He was alive through it all. But, I mean, it could have been significantly better for Yakshas. Likewise for the Sherdils. A really messy team fight. I saw Burrow Strikes coming in. The first Burrow Strike with the Epicenter actually missed because of the Lincoln Spear on the Razor.
Okay.
The Static Link, for some reason, was a whiff. It didn't catch anybody. The first Static Link, rather. And all the while, you had Nightstalker just flapping his wings and running around that battle, not really focusing a target, then trying to man fight versus a Spectre, choosing to run away. It was fortunate that Kalnayak was able to get the kill as he went down versus that Spectre, else it would have been entirely worth it for the Sherdils
here.
But again, Sherdils will find themselves in space. Rival will immediately go into the jungle and keep farming. I mean, you've got to put the pedal to the metal here on the side of Yakshas. They have to smoke and go again. They have to make some urgent plays.
Radiant are scanning for enemy.
I mean, they have a network lead, but it's going to become problematic. They are trying to find the pick off, like you mentioned. They've got Disruption, they bring him down. Appa with the double damage run.
The unfortunate bit about all these fights is that Appa doesn't have a Bloodstone. The really scary bit about the Storm is his ability to snowball out of control with his Bloodstone charges. Unfortunately, he chose to go for the Orchid instead of the Kaya first, and while it's been helping to a certain extent, I don't think it was absolutely necessary. I think they would have been just fine with Bloodstone instead, and he'd have basically been a lot bigger than he already is. Yeah? Now after every kill, he has to consider whether he goes back to base or whether he sits around for a bit longer, because he doesn't have an absurd amount of mana, regen to do either. But he'll find Wave Run. Strong with himself and
like
he'll give him the license to go in deep and make some plays.
Here I am!
I mean, it's pretty obvious what the Sherdils are trying to do here. They're trying to farm that Radiance on Rival Spectre. But the Yakshas, they realize that they have an advantage. They just need to push for objectives. And if by some chance they manage to catch Sherdils without buyback, it's pretty much the end of the game if the Razor's alive.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
He's gonna haste Tune and then consider going for that Mamacita kill. The disruption is in the vicinity.
They're giving up the last tier too.
They're trying to bring down Radiant's
and I guess they have to.
It's not a decent cause though, because Rival's on the other end of the
fallen. Dire's bottom tower is about to flounder.
And it's not like he's got the full Radiance finished up now because he picked up the recipe earlier on as well.
Sold his bond.
Radiant's top tower
and now picks
on
up the Radiance. That was when they
were times, desperate measures. All towers gone down, but the Radiance is online for Rival now. How do they approach this situation? I mean, Akrid has to steal the damage away from the Spectre if he wants to be impactful.
I think you've got to go in. Do they have vision? Okay. So they do see that a couple of heroes are in the mid lane. They did see Storm in the bottom lane. I can understand why the Sherdils are playing so defensive, because if they lose the fight now without buyback, possibly a lane of barracks for the Yakshas.
Yeah, but the Yakshas also need to play it a little slowly, I think, because Khans has the Crimson Guard in addition to the Hood. He is supremely tanky at this point in the game. And you've got the damage coming out from the Spectre. Khans can do the distraction.
Oh, two men battle smack to start things off. You got the Orchid upon the Sand King. Do not commit it. The Stampede allows Akrid to run in while Appa jumps on top of the Sand King. Quick Cold Embrace keeping the Sand King alive. Khans pops the Crimson Guard, stays alive while VP pounds away on the Kalnayak. They finally bring down the Duke and Akrid all by himself. Caught with the battle strike, caught with the Epicenter and brought down. It's a double kill for Disruption and Punk is on the run while Appa zips the hell out of there. Punk, Glimmer Cape, it's a little bit of time, but he can't run from the Radiance. Beautifully done by the Sand King in that previous fight.
Yep. Just disrespecting them, going in so deep with that dive from Appa. Trying to start a fight on the Sand King, but getting defended by the Cold Embrace from the Winter Wyvern. It wasn't just the Sand King. I mean, while the Sand King did do a fantastic job, you also had that Haunt, Radiance Burn, augmenting the damage output. Fantastic stuff coming out from them. And we now have a game on our hands. The turnaround is real.
Stupendous!
The net worth swing over that fight. Shot from nearly an 8k lead to
about a 3k net worth lead, you could say. 2 to 3k net worth swing. Good progression coming out on the side of.
They also got the Aegis, right? On the Storm? Yeah.
Yeah, he bailed. I mean, he had the Aegis, but he bailed though.
No, I mean, they managed to kill him, is what I mean.
Yeah. Now he picked up the Bloodstone. They should have been there a lot earlier if they wanted to snowball. The problem is they're just not making calls urgently enough, I think. By the time they went on the high ground, Spectre picked up the Radiance. That's a big no-no. If your lineup is meant to deal with the Spectre in the early game stage, you don't wait till she gets the Radiance at 30 minutes before you go onto the high ground.
Do you like the Orchid pickup on the Razor?
Absolutely not. I have no idea what he was thinking with that Orchid pickup. I have absolutely no idea what he was thinking with it. I wanted to see a silver
illusion.
Edge. I mean, if only for the Spectre, you go for the silver edge this game. What's that Orchid even supposed to do here? I mean, Queen's got the BKB and the U, so you're not locking her down. Sand King is. Okay. I don't think he really cares if you drop an Orchid on him after he jumped into
the
Epic and Horus. And Doom's going for a BKB of his own.
Smoke coming out from the Sherdils. Another lost fight from the Yakshas. Another lost fight could really hurt their chances here. They're smoking and they're grouping up in the mid lane. And they're trying to do the long wraparound onto the Sherdils.
this is an inefficient smoke. I mean, they're not going to find anything. If anything, they're going to be spotted out by this radiant observer.
Yeah, the smoke is dispelling. He's going to spot out Punk here and maybe in a bit.
Sherdils, they should get this tower for free. And at the same time, Appa's gone in on the middle lane and started chipping away on the tier 3. Fortification used both defensively and offensively. Top tier 2 survives a little longer while the mid tier 3 makes a bit of a beat. But the cavalry has arrived. Signs of disruption will be on the front lines. Well, Mamacita will get a tower on the top. Rival. Not only does he have the Radiant's Blade Man, he's also picked up a Yasha now. The Manta isn't too far off.
Yep. I'm gonna help
deal with the lightning.
I think they're just picking items and dropping them and pushing themselves into a corner now. I cannot understand why Akrid has an Orchid.
I know what Doom does. If I'm explaining, what do I say?
It I wouldn't like mind the Shivas or an AC.
Hero can't use any power.
Maybe a BKB.
Over a period of time, you lose health also.
I'm still a fan of the Silver Edge for him this game.
Good counter.
But I'm wondering if it's too late.
So I should ask, what advice
I think you have to go MKB either way, maybe. Just to deal with the Radiant's evasion. Oh, so is this plan here to pick up the Bloodthorn?
But what's the point?
Hey, what is the first inventory of Razor? That thing is what?
I mean, more or less. He's going for the BKB next though. Yeah, he's going for the BKB laser.
Or damage. It will be better. Okay.
Okay. We have a pause and that allows me and CloudX to place our bets. How many Roshans? I think three.
He's got two more, I'd say.
Yeah, two more. Three in total.
I'd agree with that. I don't think this game is ending before we have three Roshans.
Yeah. I'm fucked with that.
But Spectre is slowly getting to the point of being absolute nuisance. I'm not seeing a response from the Spectre on their side, but Appa. Maybe you just try and rat now. Do rat Dota is the way to go for you. They're finally going to lose a tier 1 on the bottom lane. Looks like it's going to be denied, but there are four heroes waiting on the side of Sherdils if they want to fight, but they'll be doing it without the Wind Revival.
Dire's bottom tower has been denied.
Asking if you were
in the
Akrid.
What? They TP'd out! Rival just TP'd out because.
Rival's not going anywhere though, because Appa caught him on the delayed TP. He doesn't care if he haunts now. In fact, he wants him to haunt so he goes.
I missed something. How do they know?
Plasma piece.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tower advantage.
That's a costly death on the Spectre. It's going to allow them to push, maybe for his buybacks, delay that Manta style, make that Orchid a little bit more relevant.
Why is Static Link on cooldown though?
I think he used it on the Spectre, didn't
he? Did he steal any damage?
Okay, anyway. I'm not sure what happened, but the Yakshas are marching high ground with the man advantage.
There's still a haunt, there's still a doom. That last fight that they won, by the way, was without a doom altogether. So we can see a fight breaking out successfully here. Sherdils. Up on the high ground, ready to jump in.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Sonic Wave only clipping Khalnayak, and that's more than enough to force the Yakshas to back off. Mamacita chasing forward, TP is coming out from Appa, but the U Cypher is there to control the top frame. He's low on mana, the same for it's nice, the four healers are going to search him up. Soak it up, and Appa is surely going to go down. VP hanging around for God alone knows what, will fall as well. The buyback on the Spectre paid dividends, and how?
Very big. Mamacita ends up losing his dominating streak. Appa ends up losing his dominating streak to Mamacita.
Yeah.
And the doom was committed for the storm, which is totally worth it. The plan from the Yakshas was to bait out the haunt, back away, and then come back to fight again. But unfortunately, things didn't go as planned. I mean, I didn't see a stampede available to bail from the haunt. I think they used the stampede offensively to jump in. And spotting that crucial mistake, the Spectre presses the button, buys back and presses the button. And they go all in. Yakshas are on the receiving end of the blows now, and Mamacita
as expected, there's a very loud game of Dota 2 happening.
He's only used one charge on that BKB so far.
What has been their draft like?
The problem is that the Sherdils are winning fights, but then they're not getting any tier 2s after that. They're not pushing effectively to some extent,
Rival
in my opinion.
Spectre, the main carry. And then we have Doom.
Still only not in this mid-game.
Doom is off.
A bet on Mamacita could pick up.
We have Doom.
This in the double the arcade, but he can just pop in the game. He pops the use first. Now this is BP's turn to get the silencer, but Mamacita quick with the fling. And chase down the co-op. They commit the stampede, but Mamacita pops in the carry, shows his back and blinks away. While Exit and Shinlak coming in from the east,
right,
looking to catch on
someone.
Mina Pain Illusions will disable that link deck.
Well, if that happened a little bit earlier, it might have been an opportunity, but unfortunately now the Haunt is going to be online in 6 seconds time, in 5 seconds time actually.
But
the Stampede's on cooldown.
Even if the Stampede wasn't on cooldown, they have Haunt, so they're not too worried about Stampede's out of BKB or Mamacita.
Their main
by the time the Doom cools down, you should have BKB ready.
Yeah.
Yakshas will do a good thing though. They're smart to make the Aegis and the cheese.
I think Sherdils are there. Pop the smoke in their base.
Movement speed,
and Wash Pit is the ideal location for Rival to fight.
Second on the list in terms of net worth.
No Doom for 15, so that's the one thing they're missing.
Invisibility. I mean, he's got to go in blind. This could be a Winter's Curse. Get in on the jungle. Axis pounding away on the center. It's a good way to get things started. Can't kind of walk in, but he's silenced by BP. Now, Axis turns the tent forward to do and eliminates the door. Immediate Hound coming out from Rival. He's practically turning towards Kalnag. He pops the stampede and is trying to run. Agrid's kind of burned down Mamacita's HP, but he's not doing too much. Agrid goes in onto the Winter Wild and secures the kill. Mamacita in the pit with the BKB, which is now on off. She's the challenge to use the use offensively, and this is going to be the death of the Queen of Pain. The Chain Frost, a beautiful sight to look at. And Khan buys back, but he comes back and dies again. Funk scores a double. And the Yaksha
ultimate power
get lucky
him
around the pitch.
Over time does damage.
I don't know what he did. Did
okay.
He
buy
back?
Yeah,
that was
a
buyback
when we're right in the middle of the game.
Was that a buyback on
Sanky?
The Sanky.
I don't know, we'll take a look at the
fight. Which is
so there's a buyback on Khan's in Disruption. Didn't use the epicenter.
Yeah, it's hard to tell. These guys are just Yaksha is playing better right now.
They come into the game. Yaksha shouldn't have won that fight. It was all over the place. He lit up to no extent. And he was there with what we were doing off early on. He felt like he needed to redeem himself, so he buys back into a couple of fights. But unfortunately, gets taken
back comes into the fight and dies again.
Now, this is Aegis, Cheese, and a 30-second window where they can go and go to base. There's a qualification for Bible and additional 5 right seconds against that, but so this should be a tier 3 at the very least.
It's
here.
Still balanced.
So,
okay.
One small mistake and
the Crimson Guard and the Hood on the Doom are somewhat good, but like, he's not getting the opportunity to jump in on them and get the Doom off. They're focusing the tier 3, Rival's still alive, he's completed the Manta style, which is on cooldown for the time being. They're trying their best, the Winter's Curse available, the tier 3 dropping low, they're going to get it. Kalnag gets the last hit and then moving on to the barracks. The glyph
15 seconds of the horn comes out, the 15 seconds.
They've just got to go in, they're going to give up barracks here. Disruption goes in, Barstrike to start things off on a Kalnag. Not looking for this 2-meter Barstrike.
There it
Kalnag
is.
Kalnag gets the barracks and gets out.
The Haunt's
the Winter's Curse is there on the VP, who flies away. Appa zips in, who's he gone for? He's gone for the Winter Vibe once more, while Akrid on the side is feeling a lot of damage. The Barstrike is there upon the Storm Spirit. He brings down the Winter Vibe and is still alive. He's zipping left, he's zipping right. Mamacita with the Sonic Wave. Akrid pops the cheese. The epicenter is there, they take away the Aegis. Kalnag and Akrid both dropping low, and here comes Khan. Khan is committed to Doom, but he can just run them down. They need a spectral dagger. For starters, they'll have Mamacita blinking in. The dagger is their rival trying to catch up. Well, darkness has worn out, and VP needs to be careful while Appa zips to the bounty rune, the arcane rune.
Yeah, so he didn't actually commit the Doom there. He didn't have it throughout the duration of the fight. So he was just all basically coming in and beating them up with the Mud Golem stuns and the whole boulders and whatnot.
So they got the Razor, they took the Aegis, they got Kalnayak.
They lose
the
a melee barrack for it, they force out the cheese, and now they can go take some buildings of their own. Okay. Unfortunately,
what?
There's no Haunt.
Look at this!
What the hell was that? Oh my god, that's just inviting flame upon yourself on the U Cypher stage. This is, oh man, that could be a throw right there, because Yakshas could buy back and fight.
Yeah, I mean,
the one thing they had going for them is the fact that they still had the Doom online, and now they don't have
you
it.
You can
anymore.
Just ignore the Doom. He's not going to do too much if you just let him stand in these fights and go focus someone else. Storm has been giving momentum to the top lane, so that forces Rival to TP back. More farm for him. Appa though, he's chasing Disruption. Disruption, U Cypher on cooldown, and with the outfit, he's got more than enough. He's back to 16 Bloodstone charges. It's been a game of up and down for him, but
yeah, I mean, still doing his job. It's commendable that he's made a recovery of sorts versus having one of the worst starts I've ever seen on the Storm screen. He's being very relevant in this game. He's on top of the net worth charts. This is just a full-fledged comeback of the greatest magnitude. Now the Bloodstone snowball has begun as well. So.
Yeah. Got the Lincoln Spear as well. So, Hans has his work cut out for him, and I'm not sure if BKB is really what he needs at this point.
Oh no, they've zipped him. Oh, never mind.
Just for the creep.
Shenanigans from Appa. Arcane Rune shenanigans with the Kaya.
Ah. Nighttime committed. Appa. Arcane Rune and Kaya, like you mentioned, the TPs are coming.
I actually saw this funny video where if you have an Arcane and a Kaya, you can zip from base to base. Anyway, we're gonna go in here. Tier 3, it's gonna fall, and that's the second side of the base that's been breached.
I mean, and this was actually not even stepping in. Got a haste rune on the laser.
Welcome back, he did.
This is some great
Appa just zipping around, making nuisance. And Tevza just watching as the barracks fall. Haunt wants to go in. Quick butter strike there, so Haunt. Appa zipped right out of there. Windows Curse on to VP. VP's got a Glimmer Cape. Rivals trying to find some sense of revenge. He moved on to Funk the Vision. Should be a kill onto the Lich. Sanky moves ahead with the U Scepter. Doesn't have one to keep himself alive and ends up going down to the Orchid. Mamacita unloads the Sonic Wave. I'm not even sure if that did too much, but they'll get the kill on VP if nothing else.
Now they've got
Constellation at best for the Sherdils here. Appa, unfortunately, he's low on mana. The Arcane Rune has worn off. He can zip around the pit. Kalnak with the hook.
What's he doing?
Rival is just going to run him down. Finally, Appa zips out of there, but I think his Spectre Dagger is chasing him. I'm going to keep my eyes on Appa.
No, he actually hit the dagger on.
Oh, Kalnak, if he DPs out, this is.
The dagger was on the floor, it didn't quite connect on Appa.
Okay.
He bails, he survives, but he's pretty much the only one that survives alongside Akron. But the damage has been done, right? They've taken the melee barracks, they've almost taken down the range barracks. They've just got to go in and do the same thing on the other side of the map here. That fight only began because Appa decided it's a good idea to go zipping in past and pull down that Winter Wyvern. Unfortunately for Appa, Sand King was waiting with the Butter Strike ready. Turns around, stuns him up after triggering the Lincoln Sphere, and then things just went south for them. Up until then, they just couldn't take a fight. They were thinking about going in, but they couldn't commit because they didn't have a Doom. But now Khans has the Doom, and let's hope he doesn't use it on a creep.
Stupendous.
Storm. Zipping up top again. 17 Bloodstone charges upon him. He didn't die last time.
Oh, Disruption, what have you done?
Oh no.
They've got the Winter's Curse, the Cold Embrace as well. They're going to buy Disruption sometime. Hopefully, he gets up another Barrow Strike. Barrow Strike on cooldown. Mamacita blinks ahead. Puck turns around, drops the Chain Frost. A quick use keeps Mamacita alive while Punk with the Glimmer Cape making a run for it. Screaming while he runs back to his own fountain. The Doom is there upon the Razor. Rival's getting some work done. They're trying to chase down the Razor. Instead, they turn their attention towards Appa. Appa still manning
Mama
up
Sita.
Here and wind
oh,
up.
No.
Kalnak next to him. Rival dropping low will manage to bail and get the hell out of there. Did Mamacita fall to the Chain Frost?
Yep, the Chain Frost followed him all the way to the neutral camp, bounced off the neutrals and hit him again and killed him off. Oh god, that's just some misfortune coming out for them. That's the death of the Doom for 65 seconds. No Haunt on the Spectre for 80. And a last lane of barracks left for Yakshas to claim. Can they close it out here? Or are they too low on HP? I mean, Akron's got little to no HP to work with. They have one earned charge that they can send over to him.
This is... they're actually triggering and tilting them, you know. If someone shouted at me like this during a game, I'd just go home and cry. Anyway, they go in with the epicenter. And when it misses like this, you've got to cry. The silence is there, Rivals is running in like that, but what's he going to do? Gets somebody silences him with the Orkin. Appa has gone in for this Winter Vibe and his best friend, Mamacita, possibly DKD, trying to bring down Appa. Twitch, Stampede, trying to ensure that they get the hell out of there. But the Winter's Curse, it's huge. It's good to look at, but it's not bringing anyone down just yet. Opa with the Cold Embrace staying alive. Appa low on HP, low on mana, might have to run. Rival, does he have enough to bring him down? But Appa just denies himself and ensures that he doesn't get the kill away. VP trying to TP off, but Rival, he's got the damage. He brings down the Night Stalker and he's moving on to the center. Kalyak with the Hoof Stomp, but they've got the damage. Mamacita with the auto attacks. Disruption with the Caustic. They hold on. And that is their opportunity to finally take a dig and a pot shot at their rivals.
I mean, four down on the side of Yakshas. Sherdils defends the high ground successfully. The tier 3 takes a little damage. Even the range backs on the bottom lane doesn't go down because the creeps are still pushing out on the bottom side of the map. That works out well for Sherdils. It didn't really cost them a buyback, or did it? I can't tell if the... Yeah, I think the Queen of Pain and the Nightstalker bought back over there, right? Can't be certain. That
I think the Queen of Pain bought back.
But either way, they defend, they hold on to their leads on life. Now they've got a heart on Rival.
They see Appa. Can they really? I mean, all they have to do is blink, use, and Baro Strike. Disruption wants to do just that, but whips it up. That's not the way you do it.
Rival's being silly here. Rival is being very silly here. I mean, he's got an Eagle Song just sitting in his backpack. You put it into the TP slot right now, man. Honestly, you know you're going to have to haunt in. Why would you not want your Eagle Song that you purchased?
Yeah, I agree. The plan is to haunt in. He needs the Eagle Song to be at the ready. Appa's zipping in, he's making his trigger, he's making a run for it. And Sherdils are the ones now pounding away on a tier 3. Punk goes in, Chain Frost, but yeah, if disruption and detection, Punk was certainly there. Disruption buying time with the Yule. Appa just waiting. Pops the Shivas, pulls him in with the electric vortex and gets the kill.
Okay, he's gonna TP back now. He's no longer thinking of fighting.
Yeah, they're not fighting, but Kalnayak, he's trying to wrap around now. He can find Mamacita, but where's the follow-up? He's found Mamacita, he's committed the stampede for that. But it's an axe stampede. And he said it, three Roshans.
This is so careless. I mean, I've just been watching Rival for the last 3 odd minutes, and he's had an Eagle Song just sitting in his back. I'm getting triggered looking at it. It's not such a big deal because they didn't fight, but... A little more efficiently to have your Eagle Song, I mean a 3,000 gold item sitting in your actual stash instead of your backpack, right? And now he buys a TP that's on cooldown and puts that into his backpack, so the TP's on a longer duration. I don't even know what's going on.
And I don't think the Sherdils knew that Roshan was going on. They've got money for the butterfly. Is Rival holding on to buyback? He hasn't got buyback. Why isn't he buying the Talisman of Evasion?
He can't afford it yet.
No, he can.
Oh yeah, sure he can. He can't go to the shop yet though.
Courier's got a shield. They were doing nothing. He had the gold and he was doing nothing.
I just cannot defend this what Rival is doing. It's a series of micro-level bad plays.
Is he trying to farm buyback? He's not going to get that chance. You buy that butterfly and you hope that you hold on.
Why would you buy a quarterstaff if you're going to farm buyback? It makes no sense.
I agree. I was just looking for a defense myself and
there's nothing to defend this. It's some
nothing to
stuff.
Defend, Rival.
But what's even worse is that no one on the side of Yakshas is punishing
Why
any of this.
Why are they not buying that butterfly? What?
Now he can't get to the shop, obviously, so...
Yeah, his shrine is still there, but it'd just be silly to TP hoping to buy a butterfly.
What's the point?
This is inefficiency at its finest.
Even if he wanted to TP, his TP's been in the backpack since 60 seconds cooldown. So that's...
So what is the spectre? Okay, he's moved to the enemy shop.
Finally. It took significantly longer than it had to, but he's only fortunate that Yakshas chose not to fight and push there. They're hesitating themselves.
I'm not sure the Yakshas were doing all along. Akrit's got the Bloodstone complete. He's got a BKB. The fight is looking harder.
And they've got Aegis and Cheese
for the Sherdils. Cheese on the razor. Opa looking for the Winter's Curse is just not there. Appa zips in, drops a remnant, they zip it further. They're moving on to the Winter Wyvern. Appa should get the kill with VP helping him. Rival is trying to chase down VP though. The beauty of the Sonic Wave coming out from Mamacita. Pops the BKB and runs in, but where's the follow-up? Quick butterfly coming to the leg. Who pops a refresher orb or a refresher start? Pops the stampede and is trying to turn this around. Looking for the double edge, shouldn't know who to find that kill, and Appa kind of man up versus Mamacita losing.
There's
the
something
ages.
Very wrong in each of these fights, because I never see actors with static limb damage. I'm not sure what he's doing here. It can't be that hard when you have a Sanjin Yasha and the Phase Boost to lock in a
target. Still winning this fight though. They trigger the Link, it's on the Storm, Axel doesn't care. He's got the static Link, it was on cooldown, then moved on to Rivals. Who's not got a chance to pop that late mail. Apod just running in the cold embrace, making sure that Rivals alive, and a beautiful Winter's Curse, ensuring that Kalnag takes a whole lot of damage. Mamacita moves in, and with a little bit of help from Spectre, finds the kill onto the Centaur. Rival just chasing down VP with the Desolate damage, gets that kill as well, and it's Acrid versus the world. Both of them commit the ults and try to stay alive, but it's Acrid who will fall while Appa makes a run for it. Heck, Appa could go back in.
Acrid's not factoring for the four star distance. He's basically using Static Link from max range and staying as far away as possible from the hero. In no universe does that make sense. He's got to be closer to the hero if he wants to get that Static Link damage stolen, especially when he has a BKB to deal with some of their own damage output. Now, because of those shenanigans, because of the missteps, they're going to come into this fight a little weaker. But of course, if the Doom dies like this and they find pickoffs time and again, things get harder and harder for the side of Yakshas to defend. But Appa, he's slowly getting his mana back here. He's going to be able to jump a little further down, and he tries to
Windows
DCR, but that,
Windows Curse.
No. It's on cooldown. But he had the Yules.
Yeah, he had the Yules, Disruption and Opa, just not coordinating very effectively there. Yules followed by Rush Strike. Could I cancel that TP? But yeah.
So, I mean, Razor's only a good carry if you're relying on the Static Link. By himself, he's not meant to carry. The Static Link is what makes him a carry. If you're not using that efficiently in your fights, you're wasting your entire core.
Top lane. It's not too difficult for the Sherdils to bring down the Storm Spirit, provided they can lock him down. But Disruption is just bailed, and they want to fight. I mean, they sort of want to fight, and they haven't done too much with it.
They haven't done squat with it.
So they've got these deep wards, but they haven't found a pickoff, they haven't found an objective, they didn't catch Kalnag, VP, and Punk smoking in the mid lane. Sherdils, they need to be careful, because all it takes for them, the Yakshas, is one more push and they pretty much could just put an end to this game.
Look, Yakshas,
they are moving towards the sanking. Disruption, what are you thinking? Kalnag sees him, goes in with a Hoof Stomp.
How does that even happen?
I don't know, he Butter Strike mid Hoof Stomp, but Appa zips in with the Orchid. Appa's low on mana. Disruption with the Yules will buy himself some time, but they've got detection. The four stars are there. They keep the sanking alive. And they might still be able to hold on to this game.
That looked like a bug to me. I mean, he was stunned while he butter-striked out.
I've seen this happen in games.
Makes no sense to me, but they'll survive. Spectre has the Haunt available, and she's given some momentum to the bottom side of the map as well.
She picked up another item. She's going for the Abyssal.
The Basher it is.
Yeah, she's picked up the Skull Basher. She throws away the Blade Mail, which hasn't done too much for her in this game.
But yeah, now life gets really scary if you're on the side of Yakshas. That's a stacked Spectre with evasion, with double evasion actually, and a Basher to beat up on you as well. They don't have an MKB at all on the side of the Yakshas. They have no response to this pack,
and
she's just
going to haunt. Coming up from Rival. She jumped onto VP, but VP with the Stampede trying to make a run for it. Kalnag nearby uses the Blink defensively.
What
the dagger.
What the hell are they doing,
man? Did the dagger connect? Wait, did Rival haunt again?
Nope, that was one wasted haunt by Rival, so. Yakshas should see this as an opportunity to try and finish the build.
Yeah, I mean, if Rival shows himself in the mid lane, he's pretty much
there's
done
no
for.
Doom either. So. No Doom, no Winter's Curse for a decent amount of time. What the hell did he use the Doom
on? Who was
on?
Doomed? I didn't even catch the Doom. Anyway, VP's going in. Khan's without the Doom isn't too much of a problem to deal with. Rivals here. Disruption silenced immediately. That means that they're missing the Butter Strike, but they got the damage. They should bring down VP. Rival, full men don't look back.
This.
He just pops the Flutter and he's moving forward, but there's a Chain Thrust awaiting him. An immediate Orchid upon Kalnag actually will control him a bit. The Sonic Wave ensures that Punk will fall, but Acrid, he's stealing damage by the loads, and Rival is being controlled. The Epicenter, there it's on to three, and with the Dispersion, they managed to bring them down. Appa all following himself, trying to run away with the ball lightning. He moves to the mid lane, but they've got the silence and they force him to deny himself. It's a huge victory for the Sherdils. The only problem is that everybody on the side of the Yakshas has buyback to work with.
Literally everyone has buyback. They're going to buyback, and again, this is going to end up in a stalemate by the looks of it. The major source of damage there was not just the Epicenter, it was also the Dispersion damage coming out from Rival, who was standing next to four heroes or five heroes next who were beating up on him. Razor stole a lot of damage in that fight, managed to turn it around on Rival, but Rival, because the break mechanic doesn't kick in on him, turns around and smacks them with the Dispersion.
Oh, they've gone in for more. It's Punk.
Or die back.
And yeah.
This is the beginning of the end here. This is the beginning of the end. No one is buying back now.
Appa's respawning in 8, but by himself he can't do much. I think they're just pocketing a lane of lags. And for the first time in the entirety of Season 1, the Yakshas are playing with their back against the wall. How do they respond under pressure? The Sherdils are testing them.
One lane of barracks taken down. They're going for the next now with the tier 3 apart as well.
BP can't do it by himself. That's the buyback. Disruption goes in with the butter strike. They're controlling BP. Appa zips in, zips right, zips left, but he hasn't managed to do much. Mamacita pops his BKB, can make a run for it. They've done damage, they're looking to escape. But BP has the stampede. Disruption with the quick butter strike. They won the Sand King. They should get the Sand King. They've got enough detection, but they don't get anything else. That's 99 seconds without the Sand King, but he's got buyback. And Rival, he's almost got his Abyssal Blade complete.
They sacrificed the Sand King deliberately there for that one. Mamacita, quick Yules coming out there, sending Khalnayak into the air. He does have a way to fight forward here, but for now I think he's just contented dealing with this massive creep wave. They want to keep momentum going, they need to start pushing out this top lane ASAP.
So Rival has a lot of gold, but once again the courier is just chilling.
I think it's time to go finish that Abyssal Blade.
Yeah.
There okay, it is.
There he goes.
That's a fully stacked Spectre. I mean, at this point, you probably
Moonshots?
Just get... Yeah, Moonshot and Boots of Travels. That's the only things left for him.
Yeah. She's got money for the BOTs, but now it makes sense to hold on to
buy
back.
Yeah,
buyback.
It most definitely does. Oh, you could also so get Refresher out.
Port Rosha. I think they have to contest.
Refresher Shard is on the floor for this one. It would be beautiful if the Spectre could get it. They have the Haunt. They're not making their way into the pit. They've scanned them, tagged them. They're going to reach here in time.
I don't think they're going to reach.
Yeah, they're not even trying.
They're not even trying.
So who holds on to the Refresher Shard here? Is it the Lich or the Center? It's the Center. 40% damage reduction twice. Yeah, I guess that makes sense.
Well, the net worth advantage in favor of Sherdils, but I'm not sure they're in the driver's seat just yet. Appa dips in, immediate Orchid, they have the Abyssal. Appa's gotta be careful. Actually, Rival committed it, but they've got the Doom! They've controlled the Storm Spirit! He has the Aegis, they burn through that, and VP flying around in the trees gets controlled by the Butter Strike. They commit the Sonic Wave, and there's the Haunt. Rival ensuring that Opa stays alive through all of this, but accurate with his BKB. He's ripping the Spectre, a new one. The Cold Embrace is going to buy him time, but the Chain Frost is there. They've lost the Spectre, they've lost the Winter Wyvern, and accurate is moving forward for more. Mamacita, low on HP, blink on cooldown. Appa zips in, the Ucypher is going to buy him time, but he's dead. A remnant awaits him, and Rival runs in. The Hex is there, the Epicenter, sort of underwhelming. Rival needs a little bit of lockdown if he hopes to find kills. They've managed to bring down the Night Stalker, they've chewed through the Aegis. But the rest of them are still around. And somehow Appa goes in deeps and gets brought down. They're moving in for more. Kalai, he's low on HP. He's looking to DP out, but the bash is there. While Mamacita blinks ahead, searching for Akrid.
Kalai
still trying to bail, through all of this, but
is just waiting for him, yeah. That's
going
to be a death on the center. That's a death on the center, the Storm Spirit, and the Night Stalker. It did cost a couple of buybacks on the side of Sherdils, but they can push once again. All of that was with an Aegis, Cheese, and a Refresher Shard.
Was the Refresher Shard committed?
It was committed. Centaur has 7,000 gold at this point. He hasn't purchased his next item. That'll possibly add another layer in their defense, but I don't know if it's too late at this point, because Sherdils are just marching down mid. They're going to go for the top lane of barracks, I assume.
Yep.
No okay. Fortification around this time either.
So, that's going to become costlier and costlier. I mean, Rival is not holding on to buyback. He doesn't have any... Kalnag buys back, and it looks as if the Sherdils will come take a look at the Yakshas base another day.
So Kalnag bought back and purchased a 10-second BKB. That's his new item pickup. Mamacita is also going to be able to take down this shrine on his way out of the base. And I actually think you just wait for 17 seconds and you go again. When the Haunt is back online, you've taken a fight versus Aegis Cheese and Refresher Shard,
and
you're going to win a fight without it.
Yeah. AP on the hunt, Stampede committed, they're looking to get rival. They have vision to commit the sheep. The Khalnak is there with a hoofstock. Can they keep the Spectre alive? A death on her would be costly, but she manages to survive. Pops the Mantosile, has the haunt, and could turn around. They're moving on to Appa. They haven't got the Doom. They committed it elsewhere. The haunt is there. The Butter Strike will whiff, but the Abyssal wasn't there quick enough. Khalnak with a quick three-man hoofstomp, securing his team's retreat. Can Mamacita blink forward and catch someone with the Yule Scepter? Blink on cooldown. Punk. Well, Punk is going to be the scapegoat.
Yeah, he's going to buy as much time and space as he can. In fact, he's going to end up surviving.
Yeah.
It's a bit crucial as well, because he's still holding on to the Chain Frost here.
And he's got an Axe.
He's got an Aghanim Scepter. All right, that's going to work very well versus the army of illusions and haunt replicas on the floor.
Yep.
But to summarize, that's a dead Night Stalker for 50 seconds. No haunt on the side of the Spectre. And top lane, you've got some rat shenanigans coming out from Appa. The range barracks has already fallen, by the way. Appa, oh no, he zipped right in. He's gone in for the kill on Winter Wyvern.
For the Winter Wyvern, but have they got enough to control the Storm Spirit? No,
nope.
They haven't.
He's back out again. And they didn't even kill the Winter Wyvern. Space created, I guess. But for what, honestly? Because you're shaving off time that the Haunt could be back online in.
Yeah.
That last fight though, I mean, you had a Storm zipping in from downtown, trying to go in on Rival. Unfortunately, he missed with the zip damage. The moment he comes in and they try and bring down the Spectre, Spectre's just too tanky.
They're going for Mamacita with the Sheepstick. I think they have enough. The Hoofstomp is there. They've got
That's a dieback!
That's 130 seconds without the Queen of Pain. You've got to respect the range from which the Storm can get a fight started. And Mamacita pays with his life there. What do the Yakshas do with this? Are they looking for Roshan once more? Roshan's not even up. May respawn in 3 minutes 30 seconds. What's the plan for the Yakshas? They could keep looking for pickoffs like this with the Storm Spirit.
I mean, I don't think you look for pickoffs anymore. I think you just go for green.
Okay.
Green is dead for 9. You're not going to get a better numbers advantage.
Push the creep wave, try and end. What you got to do?
Yeah, that's basically the
one
game.
One melee barracks is all that stands, and Sherdils have recognized this as well. They're smoked up, they're standing in base. They're looking for the Yakshas to clump up. Rival moving forward, Akrid focusing the barracks.
The static link is there.
He steals
the
a bit of damage, but he got the Doom upon Akrid. Akrid doesn't care. He's just focusing the barracks. The glyph is not coming out. Lots of spells being thrown left and right, but finally Rival goes in with the Abyssal Blade upon Akrid. Khalnak is there with the Hoof Stomp. The barracks have fallen. Yaksha's objective gaming has paid off. And Appa, well, he's still alive through all of this. Quick Orchid onto the Sand King. He's moving forward for more. Disruption has the Lotus off. Turns around with the Butter Strike. Appa still alive through all of this. And look at that. They've controlled both of them with the Hoofstomp. The Haunt comes out. Rival is trying to scurry away, but they managed to bring down the Spectre. Disruption. There's not much he can do. In team chat, Rival has called it. He might as well call it in all chat. But I think the Yakshas have done it.
They've done it. They managed to take the win. Alright folks, looks like things have gone south on the main stage. We're gonna call it a wrap here because clearly Yakshas have taken the victory. This is CloudX and Vivek signing out for now. We'll see you later.
Hey, jump!
Idhar se bahar jaana to do.
Amar
the rules.